Welcome back. Young people are often advised to follow their passion when they're looking to start a new career. But a new study shows this advice may actually limit career choices and worsen the gender gap, particularly for women in STEM. Here to explain is editor of Forbes Women, Maggie McGrath, along with the vice chair of the Forbes and Know Your Value 3050 Summit, Huma Abedin. Great to have the team back together. Maggie, what did the researchers find here?
Mika, this research is really interesting. It found that when students and adults of all genders are given the advice to follow your passion, they were more likely to choose jobs that are consistent with gender stereotypes, which is to say women were more likely to choose jobs in art and healthcare, men were more likely to choose jobs in science and business. And yet, when the advice changed and these students and adults were told, pick a job that leads to security, better benefits, higher pay, mm-hmm. the gender divide decreased. Women were more likely to choose jobs in STEM fields like computer science and engineering. And I think the takeaway here, it's really important. We're not saying that people need to be miserable in pursuit of money, but we do know that career choice is one of the largest drivers of the gender pay gap. So what these researchers are recommending is that women and girls are exposed to things like computer science and accounting from a young age, so they know they have an interest and could pursue those fields later on.
So Huma is a perfect example of someone who had a thriving career in politics, an industry that is overwhelmingly male. Huma, what's your advice to young women who are starting out or thinking about starting a career that's in a traditionally male-dominated field?
You know, I always tell young women, particularly women who are entering the workforce for the first time, to consider doing the thing that scares them the most. Because when you're talking to women in their early 20s, they're mostly deprogramming almost a decade of this sort of these social norms that start in, frankly, there's plenty of evidence to say, starts in middle school, where girls in primary school are raising their hands just as much as boys, and then insecurities about how they look and how they feel about themselves lead them to raising their hands and increasingly less and less. So to try things that scare you, that you may not be good at, I mean, this is all about developing skills. You know, when I started in politics, I used to whisper, and I didn't know that I wanted to be in politics. Nobody around me was in politics, men or women. But if you consider doing something that maybe makes you uncomfortable or that you're scared of doing, the whispering will lead to talking, and that will lead to leading.
So for many women, practicality rules the day, where they need to go into something that's going to, you know, put food on the table. Mm-hmm. So for me, the follow your passion advice has a lot to do with our 50 over 50 list, the long mm-hmm. runway, because mm-hmm. I think this advice, Huma, can apply to women who are mid-career or yes. who are looking to make pivots and finally get to their dreams.
Yes. And also, I think women learning something new. I mean, I think the day you get up and think, okay, I can do this with my, you know, eyes closed, and but you feel stagnant, you feel like you aren't learning and you have opportunities. And the reality is people pursue careers that aren't necessarily, making you feel financially secure. The number of my friends who are also in their late 40s who feel financially secure, it is shocking. And I put myself in that bucket. And so you're never too early. You know, Mika, I feel like this is something you've taught me. You're never, quote unquote, too old to try something new, to learn something new. It might be scary to do it, but it's at least worth trying. You don't want to look back with regret.